All right, you know what it says, but let me tell you what it means. If any of you are planning on making unauthorized copies of this tape for your mother or sick relative, do not. We know where you live. Now, enjoy the rest of the show.
Everybody, I'm Ron Lancaster, and for the next little while, I'll be your host as we take a look at the world of professional football. You know, football's been my life for a long time. I started playing when I was 9 years old back in Clairton, Pennsylvania. However, back then, I could run a lot faster. Well, maybe not. Maybe I couldn't run a whole lot faster. But anyway, football took me on to Wittenberg University and then eventually to the Canadian Football League, where I played for 19 years. You know, when you watch a game at home, you hear about the time that each player spends on conditioning and training, but what you don't know about are the hours and hours of research and study that each Canadian Football League player must spend before he ever sets foot on the gridiron. In a sense, there's a full curriculum that each rookie must subscribe to, and that's what we're going to look at today. Okay, guys, back to work. You'll see the big hits, the key players, some great tackles, and some bad bounces. But you'll also have a sneak peek at the classes that each and every CFL player must take. So sit back and come with me on a whirlwind trip through a professional football player's field of study. And remember, if you're caught cheating, it's a penalty. It's in here that the CFL rookie starts to learn the basics of the Canadian game. There are many differences between our game and the game they play in the States. So let's take a peek at the introductory lesson of Rules 100. And don't be surprised if a little history has slipped in, just for good measure.
And now, here are some of the different facets of the Canadian game that make it unique. First, let's begin with the field of play. In order to complete a touchdown run, the total distance is 100 yards. No, that is incorrect. The Canadian field is 10 yards longer, hence the player must go further to score. Each team fields 11 men at a time. Also incorrect, there are 12. Backfield movement is limited. Not in Canada, the entire backfield may move, making for a multiplicity of diverse plays. During a punt, the fair catch rule is operative. That is a fallacy. In Canada, once you have fielded the ball, you're dead meat, metaphorically speaking. After receiving the ball, you are allowed to return it through foot propulsion. Yes, kicking it back is legal. Football consists of four downs. Not so in Canada. We are content with only three, one less in mathematical terms.
The Grey Cup Trophy is a symbol of football supremacy in Canada, and it all began in 1909, and that's before I even came in the league, on a Rosedale field in Toronto. Things really got moving in 1948 when the Calgary Stampeder fans descended on Toronto and made the championship game for the Grey Cup into a festival. In the 1950s, Edmonton Eskimos dominated the league and Jackie Parker became part of folklore when he returned the Chuck Kunsinger fumble 90 yards for a touchdown. Fair play notwithstanding, sometimes the rules were broken.
The Winnipeg bench, and he is boiling, and no wonder.
A few characters like Jim Trimble, Bud Grant, and Joe Capp, who enjoyed success in Canada, went on to fame in the U.S. game. Meanwhile, Russ Jackson stayed at home and led the Ottawa Rough Riders to some impressive Grey Cup victories. My old friend and teammate had some great teams in Ottawa, but even good teams have to have a little bit of luck, as seen here in 1968, when Vic Washington gets the Argo bounce and goes on for a touchdown to defeat the Calgary Stampeders. I was involved in some big games, and in 1976, though, I was powerless as Notre Dame's Tom Clemens teamed up with Tony Gabriel.
Gabriel is open in the end zone. Touchdown! And the Ottawa fans declare the going crazy.
Tom Wilkinson and his successor, Warren Moon, led the Edmonton Eskimos to five consecutive Grey Cup championships. From 1978 to 1982, they completely dominated the league. Exciting finishes have always been part of the Grey Cup game. In 1987, a Jerry Couric field goal gave the Eskimos the title. In 1988, an interception by Michael Gray preserved the Winnipeg victory.
Deflected and intercepted. Michael Gray.
And after 23 years, my old team, the Saskatchewan Roughriders, won their second Grey Cup in 1989.
And with a football footnote, please welcome Professor Neil Lumsden.
This is where the Grey Cup legacy began, here on Rosedale Field, a park which sits in one of Canada's most exclusive neighborhoods. I'm sorry.
No.
Hopefully, we can get the safety man to come to that side of the field. If he does, it gives the wide receiver time to go down, break to the inside, and come up this seam. If we get him the ball in that seam, we score a touchdown. You got it? The aptitude for playing football begins with the fundamental ability of communication, which in other words mean if you're going to play football, you have to understand it. The responsibility for leading his players both on and off the field falls into the hands and the mouths of the coaches. The coach has to come here every year for one semester just to brush up on his communicative skills. And as you will see later, that preparation will pay dividends. Here Coach John Gregory shows how to astutely answer any interviewer's keen question.
Well, they're doing a nice job in that, and we do have to get him stopped. Okay?
Each head coach is always in complete command.
Well, we believe they're talking about the designated import rule.
And the ball's dipped, there's no interference!
Hey, how you call timeout when he's got his hands under the... I don't understand that.
Just let me finish.
That's illegal.
Well, I think it moves sideways.
Who said he can't play
quarterback?
Well, you changed the rules from last year.
I'll see it in the film. But he can move.
That's
it. He's a DI. He can play any position he wants.
No matter what, coaches have learned how to keep cool, calm, and collected under any adversity.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be happy. Cause when you worry, your face will frown, and that will bring everybody down. So don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now.
The leader on the sidelines is a coach, then the man at the control in the field is the quarterback. Each pivot in his own right embodies the quality of a Rhodes Scholar, and all the hours of study pay off once they take the field.
you know, we quarterbacks always do our best to hit the receivers on the numbers. But sometimes, the ball ends up in the wrong hands. Look, here we're back in the pocket and squeeze it. Oh my gosh. We don't practice those, they just happen. Big catch, turn around, get. Butterfingers. Now this one, he had no right missing that ball. Watch this. Up, now we pick it up, and here's the long bomb right in the hands. No, it isn't. It's in his hands. It's enough to give us nightmare. Touchdown run and kick and bounce and watch this. It's enough to give you gray hairs. Now here on the long bomb, going, going, gone. And when we reach the end zone, the ball goes to someone else. It's not only plays like these that drive us crazy. Sometimes the lines of communications break down.
Nowhere to run to, baby. Nowhere to hide. Got nowhere to run to, baby. Nowhere to hide. It's not love I'm running from. It's the heartbreak I know when it comes. But I know you're looking for me. But you become a part of me. Everywhere I go, your face I see. Every step I take, you take.
Once again, here is an educational moment with Neil Lumsden.
Beginning in 1911 and through to 1957, there was a record 30 Grey Cups games played here. As if half that. A record 30 Grey Cup games was played here. Were played here. A record 30 Grey Cup games were played here.
An all-star cast in a story they didn't want told. Suspense. Romance in Murder in the Backfield. John Gregory is the desperate coach.
He just killed our quarterback, too.
Matt Dunnigan, the vigilante who fights back. The authorities were baffled. There were plenty of suspects. Was it the deranged psycho? Or a gang of teenage ninjas?
You know why? Because they can't stop us.
Be there when the finger pointing begins. Tension. Horror. Scantily clad women. That and more in Murder in the Backfield. Some scenes not suitable for mature audiences.
Hey, Luna, hey, Mama, hey, Daddy, Poochie, John, and Georgia, Eric, and Jacksonville, Shuley, and Gainesville, Auntie, Grandmama.
Repeat after me. Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hi.
One of the essential fields of study is the basic verbal skills. These skills are reinforced in a lecture series as well as in language laboratories like this one. Before a professional football player can go on the field, he has to be able to communicate, first with his coach, then with his teammates, and even from time to time with the opposition.
Hey, Rumpel, your first slap, go for it again! Go for it again!
Hi, Rena. Hi, Mama. Hi, Daddy. Hey, my little sister at University of Florida. What's up, baby? I'm seeing some money later on.
Their hard work pays off when television requires them to be spokesmen for the team.
Be a part of the great triple threat.
Be part.
Be part of a great... Wait a minute, start over.
Be a great part of... Oh, man.
It's okay.
Be a part of a great triple, what is it?
One-on-one on the Canadian Football Network. Cut. Be part of the Canadian, I got it this time.
Be part of a great Canadian.
One-on-one.
One-on-one on the great, what am I saying great for?
Hey, let's see what you have some better than that.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Earl the Pearl. Be part. Is that be a part?
No.
You, me. Can I go now?
Yeah. So Al, you're in the slot. You cut right and give a wave. Then Dave, when you pick up the sideline camera here, give a quick hi, Mom, and don't forget to say hello.
How you doing, Mom and Dad? You watching on cable? Good.
What's up, Pete? Hey, what's up, homeboy?
Hey, Pete, nice to see you. We love you.
Gotta keep coming, baby. Gotta keep coming.
How you doing?
It's 2 in a row. We coming. And we ain't finished yet.
Hey, I'm starting early. That's one already. I might get 4 today, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Chelsea, Jillian.
Davey Boy.
My wife.
Hi, Mom. My dad.
Hi, Christopher.
Hey, Leo. Quit eating them hot dogs up there. You're getting kind of big in here.
Verbal skills are important, but also penmanship is stressed, as is evident here with some students' first semester projects. Here, a student demonstrates how to say hello and pay off a debt, while a freshman publicizes his favorite soft drink. Some undergrads show their TV viewing preference, while others issue opponents a strong warning. Sometimes, though, what starts out as a good idea ends up making no sense at all. Personal grooming habits are another area in which a professional football player is schooled. Here is Professor John Mandridge, who majored in hair design before he graduated.
You know, this is where it all begins.
Now, some personal grooming hints. Here's the military look, simple yet practical. The ring around the collar cut makes its own fashion statement. Next, the off-the-ear design, chic and built for speed. Now, this look is out, 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 out! And finally, the insignia for the team player who shows he cares. Highlighting the eyes is important, and it should be practical as well as attractive. This season, we are not only seeing the traditional solo line under the eye, we have branched out to the inverted V look. And from there, other letters of the alphabet should soon follow. And remember, always keep abreast of latest in music trends.
Headbands are now almost mandatory. And here is faculty member Bobby Jurison with a helpful hint on head coverings.
Usually I get my hair wet before I do it. Twist it in back. Tie a knot. Fix the edges. Check if you got it where you want it. And there you have it.
What we strive for in the classroom is preparation. Preparation under any circumstance. You know, the Canadian brand of football is tough. With the differences in climate and the extreme weather conditions in this country, it's no wonder that one of the prerequisite courses offered is in meteorology. Hey guys, let's take a look at this film.
Although the weather conditions are not exactly ideal on the field of play, you must learn to utilize these minor inconveniences to your advantage. Lack of proper field maintenance combined with undue precipitation can cause minor problems with the field. I hope those aren't cowboys out there. Excessive water is not good for your lungs as well. In such a circumstance, remember to inhale the air and not the water. Is there a lifeguard handy? Now, the wind occasionally plays a factor in the Canadian game, especially on a kick. In this example here, the ball travels 40, no 30, no 20, no 10. It doesn't go very far. The most hazardous conditions occur during inversion when the cold air is kept under the warm, resulting in fog.
The quarterback is back in the pocket and he hands it off to someone who's coming up wide up the middle, and it's a whistle.
All right, where's the ball?
Harry, where's the ball?
Harry, where are you? Where's anybody?
But when the weather conditions are ideal, then you can see the Canadian game at its best, play the way it should be. under a clear sky with no adverse conditions to affect the outcome of the game. Each athlete is able to demonstrate their abilities to the fullest. The weather can be deceiving. Even when the conditions are perfect, they can change rapidly. A quick, isolated shower can happen at any time.
You know, there's no substitute for hard work and relentless study. We make it mandatory for each one of our players to watch these plays and to learn from the best.
They got to kick 6 field goals to beat us.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Hey, just stay on the top.
You know, we're going to be looking at some great plays in the CFL, but I had to get this one in there. Sometimes a quarterback gets a little bit lucky. You just throw the ball up and let a guy like Bob Richardson make the catch for you. That's my play for this reel, but let's sit back and watch some great players in the Canadian Football League.
Look at this return by Hanenaka.
Nice hit.
And now another moment with Neil Lumsden.
Parker's touchdown in this end zone started Edmonton off to its first of 3 straight wins over the Alouettes and ruined a great drive for... My lips are freezing. And ruined a great drive... Oh. Ready?
Roll!
What? And ruined a great day for Red O'Quinn. O'Quinn. O'Quinn.
After you've learned the prerequisite courses, there's always a chance to study unique plays like these. Some of these are so unique, they've never been tried again. Guys, it's the other side of the field.
Hey, let's see, this is the fake punt now. This is the fake punt.
Now take the punt for us. Usually they kick the ball, but sometimes the punter can throw. And sometimes the punter just stands around
while they put a quarterback in to throw the ball. And sometimes a quick kick, it can get you great field position. You can fake a field goal and sometimes put it right up the middle. Or fake the field goal and throw a pass. But that pass is to a lineman. Is that fair? And there's lots of versions of a flea flicker. There's this one that everybody knows. And then they come up with a new version called the tossback. Say what you want, but the game is fair. Everybody gets a chance to throw the ball in this game. Sometimes you're not sure where to throw the ball. Just throw it in the end zone. Hopefully something good will happen. Your guy will catch it. Halfbacks always want to be passers. Pretty nice pass. This time, the running back wants to throw a pass to the quarterback. They've always wanted to be receivers anyway. Sometimes on a kick, you can return it yourself or give it to your friend. Or if you really don't want the ball, you can always kick it back. But some people are determined to give up the pigskin. So in that case, the only alternative is to take it back all the way. And with this play, you are guaranteed to earn a PhD. But sometimes your plans fall apart. And when they do, you must improvise in a hurry.
But what makes a great player is his ability to take what he's learned in the classroom and bring it right here to the field. Okay, guys, let's show him. Ready? Hut.
Okay, it is just practice.
The game of professional football takes many hours of intense preparation.
He's my roommate, and oh god, I'm getting really tired of this little video.
With their nose constantly to the turf, the players have little time for fun or frivolity. Before a rookie can play, the student council puts them through their own special graduation ceremony.
Each and every one of these guys, when they least expect it.
And I didn't do it.
They did it.
Their clothes are going.
I can't believe it.
After practice, you've got to hit the showers. Or the showers hit you. The mental preparation is strenuous. Before a player takes the field, he must be in touch with all facets of himself and his psyche. Because of the intense physical nature of the game, we study the basic animal instinct that each player must call upon.
Don't forget, men, this is a vicious game. You've got to be animals out there. Animals! It's time for the bloopers.
I got it. Huck one. Whoop. Hey, that's me. I gotta pick it up myself. Oh, ow. Foot. Hey, I'm on your team. What are you doing?
Have you met a net?
Hey, here's the gas pedal.
Ooh, nice buns.
Did we practice this? Ow.
Hey, it's a wishbone offense. I wish I had my bone.
Annette, you again.
Water. 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 Whoa.
I got it.
Oh, yeah, I guess I better pick it up now. I gotta pick it up if I know it's out.
That's good work out there. Good defense.
That's the end of the half. All right, if you know the answer to our trivia question, give us a call.
Is the answer six?
Don't call me at work.
The duck-billed platypus?
Colonel Mustard with the lead pipe in the lavatory.
28 egg rolls, 14 orders of sushi, and one mama burger and fries with all of them.
We had no winner, so it's back to the game.
Come
Come on, defense, make a play out there!
Hey, get out of the way! Where's my close-up? Sorry about that.
Glad it's foam.
Think I need a shave? I thought the field was wider. I know I left a bone here somewhere. Wouldn't you guys see my lunch? Get under the passes. You take it. No, you take it. Nope, it's mine. Get the game straight. Look, I don't know where your bone is, all right?
The average fan does not realize the degree of precision that is taught in order that each player can execute those tricky moves that occur when they reach the optimum goal of the game, the touchdown.
Yo, check out us out as we cross the line. 6 more points on the move to survive. Celebrate and put your hands in the air. People take note as you shake a dairy air. Soar like an eagle, get down with the friends. We make a big play, celebration begins. Slapping hands, high fives and more. Boy, I really feel good when I score. Point in the air and let it be known. When I move on the field, I'm the king of the throne. TDs or sacks, it don't matter, you see. When we shred our good stuff to get on TV. Spike the ball, put it down, be proud. Or be a nice guy and send it to the crowd. Circle and dip, put you all in a trance. Then end it all off with a buffalo stance. March, groove, skip, twist, flip in the air. I move how I feel without a don't care. Eddie the eagle always seems to appear. This is my time, so watch and just cheer. 6-gun salute will always do. You can even bounce a ball off your helmet too. Maybe 6'4", 300 pounds. Doesn't mean I can't groove and get on down. Feel so darn good when I make a grand play. I let it be known in my own special way. Inside and let me tell you when we score in advance. Just can't help it, see how I dance. The football dance is what it's all about. Fun on the field without a doubt. Last place coming, now we're down by 2. Touchdown, time to boogaloo, hit it.
It's a cold, hard fact of life that not everyone who comes here to become a professional football player will make the grade. So for those who flunk out, there's only one alternative. They become referees.
Almost midway between the sidelines, the snap to him is good. He gets the kick away, and it's very high, not too long. Coming down here, and it hits the official right on the head.
And now, here's referee Harry Bowden with a few new rules for this coming year.
Thank you. Please watch out for the following penalties. Pretending to be an airplane. The penalty call is like this, and it comes with a 5-yard loss. Next, uncoordinated dancing or unrhythmic celebration after a big play. This will signify the call and a 10-yard penalty. And finally, excessive physical contact with the cheerleader. This is what the call looks like, and it will carry a 15-yard assessment and possible divorce. Thank you and play safe.
The referees are always under fire, taking flack from players, coaches, and fans. They must rule with an appropriate sense of fair play and justice, and learn to understand when a player gets carried away if a call doesn't go his way. Each official must approach his work with diligence and has to believe he's always right, whatever call he makes. And many a time, the coaches wish the shoe was on the other foot.
And now, let's go to the referee's highlight reel and some of their key hits this past season. Before each game, the officials check to make sure their eyesight is in top form. Here's some good broken field running by number 38. And here's a key block by 21 that almost frees him up. Watch this bomb and see how number 35 makes sure the receiver is going nowhere. I think he's making a uniform change here.
Back to the action. Here's 41 with a key stop to save a sure TD. Here a draw play turns into a sandwich for 38. Watch a good goal line stand by 65. That's a legal motion on 31. And 55 running some interference. Here the referee checks the uniform to make sure there's no stick-em.
It's Neil Armstrong again.
What's that? I played in that game, and I remember it all too well. That rain-plagued Grey Cup game, more than any other factor, contributed to the building of the Sky Dome. Toronto knew if it was ever to host another Grey Cup game, it needed a new facility. That rain-plagued Grey Cup game, more than any other factor, led to the building of the Sky Dome.
And now, here are a few words from the 1989 class valedictorian, Chris Walby. Chris?
You can see the quarterbacks. You can see the running backs, the flashy wide receivers, but you have to be here in the stands to really appreciate where the action is won and lost. And I'm talking about in the pits, the offense and the defensive line going at it like wild boars in a feeding frenzy.
This year, we'll be adding a correspondence course for you, the fan. So why not take a few moments to see what's on your curriculum?
That's right, friends. You too can learn how to be part of a Canadian Football League crowd in just a few short weeks. You'll discover the secrets of the wave. How to ignore the weather conditions. and much, much more. Learn about face painting, wardrobe, makeup, and discover the secrets of how to drink through a straw while wearing a pig mask. And then it's on to the second term, where you can major in the animal of your choice. And finally, it's postgraduate time, where you can obtain a doctorate in pyrotechnics. Remember, these are trained professionals. Do not try this in your own home.
Well, that's our look at what it takes to make a professional football player. Next time you watch a game, remember all the time, study, and preparation it took to get these gridiron graduates to the football field.
That's football.
A game of football.
While in Toronto, production staff of CFL The Spectacular huddled at the fabulous Skydome Hotel. The Skydome Hotel, truly the world's first adventure-class hotel.
Hey, don't touch that remote. A lot of people put a lot of hard work in this video, and you won't want to miss their name, now would you? And besides, we ain't done yet.
Okay, it was a good one. Who's got the scissors?